You can import Excel data either during the seller setup process or from the product section after the setup is complete. Before we import Excel data into Way2Order, we should have our Excel file ready. You can download the Excel template from here. If I open the downloaded Excel template, you'll see column headers for all the attributes you have. This template includes only the attributes for which the data can be imported to Way2Order using an Excel file. You will have to fill in this Excel file and then upload it back to Way2Order. Please make sure that you do not rearrange or reorder the columns in the downloaded Excel template file. Please refer to our separate video on how to prepare your Excel data for import. Do not delete the header though. Make sure that the product attribute cell type and maximum character limit has been met. The app automatically truncates the excess text in every cell if maximum characters exceed the limit. I'll browse the file with errors first. We have three errors which are highlighted in red. Let's see what they are. Article code, MRP, and warehouse fields cannot be blank. These errors are in rows number 3, 8, and 13. Let's cancel the import and make corrections to the Excel file. Now I'll browse the correct file. We do not have any errors now. A maximum of 1,000 rows of data can be imported in one go. If your Excel file contains more than 1,000 rows, then only the first 1,000 rows will be imported from sheet 1. The other sheets in your Excel file are not read. The unique values in code, category, and warehouse columns are read and are displayed on the left. We can see we have these codes, 23 categories, and 2 warehouses. Let's quickly review the column data before we import it. Everything looks good, so let's continue. The data mapping dialog enables us to map any category that was already defined in our previous import. For example, we already have a category named bronze. In the new Excel file, we again have the bronze category. I've named it bronze new on purpose. If we import this Excel data without mapping categories, we will have two bronze categories, which is not what we want. That is where data mapping comes in handy. Let's tell data mapping that the new bronze category is the same as the existing bronze category and map them. So the new bronze category is the same as the existing bronze category and let's map it. Yes, we want to map this. Likewise, we can map all the categories and warehouses, etc. till all the duplicates are eliminated. When we are done, we can click Data Mapping Complete, save Excel data to the server. Data mapping does not work for the product attribute code. If your product or article code has already been defined or added in Way2Order and you wish to add additional variations for that code, then you will have to manually insert that data by editing the code from the product section. If you import that code again in the Excel file, then the app will create duplicate codes, wherein old variations will be included in the old code and new variations in the new code. When you're finished mapping data, click Data Mapping Complete, save Excel data to the server.